you're describing Earth turning under a ball to negate a straight path, according to you, without any demonstrations. But according to you, balls don't ever fall straight. So if I drop a bowling ball and a feather in a vacuum chamber, according to you, it'll hit the sides! Yeah, I've got plenty of examples that don't seem to show that, though, my friend. Nevertheless, despite your nonsense about balls never being capable of being dropped straight, because according to you, Earth turns underneath them, Earth doesn't turn under drones. So that's a contradiction, my friend.
Nathan, that's exactly what I said before. I'm not sure if the Earth turns below them. I wouldn't say it like that.
Oh, well, why would you say it about the ball, then?
Paul,
why would you say it about the ball, then? It's not an either-or scenario. Either Earth turns underneath stuff not attached, or it doesn't. It's not either-or. It's not circumstantial. Well, maybe it'll turn underneath. It either turns underneath or it doesn't.
Nathan, I would say it like the ball is moving away from the linear or circular path of the object or the person who let it go.
Yeah, because Earth turning underneath it, according to you.
No.
Yeah! What do you mean, yeah, moving away from its straight path because it's claimed by you Earth turns underneath it. Yes, Nathan. Pat, got your tongue? Not sigh. Yes, Nathan. I claim it moves from its straight path because Earth, I am claiming, is turning underneath it until I point out that a drone hasn't got Earth turning underneath it and then suddenly it's selective, is it? No, mate, just a contradiction. Your silence is absolutely demonstrative of your cognitive dissonance.
Nathan, look, the thing, I want to continue with my ball. We can discuss about the drone later.
Oh, I see. So we'll stick with the one where you assert that the ball's got Earth turning underneath, will we? And ignore the fact that Earth doesn't turn under the drone. We'll just come back to that later after you assert multiple times, having already said it twice, that Earth turns under a ball.
Okay, Nathan, one question.
Earth turning under a ball we're going to talk about, but we're not going to talk about Earth turning under a drone, right? That's what you want.
No, Nathan.
No, that's what you've just asked for. We'll focus on Earth turning under the ball, and we'll ignore Earth not turning under a drone, because that would leave me in cognitive pain. That's what you've essentially just said.
No, the thing with the drone is the drone has motors and everything, which keeps it up.
Oh, I see. We're back to this shit. Where the drone is keeping up with 1,000 miles an hour, how powerful do you think the drone's motors are?
No, the drone's already moving 1,000 miles an hour.
Oh, I see. So we've not got any drift then. So the ball's already moving at 1,000 miles an hour then. So the ball's not drifting anymore
and
then.
We are also moving.
So the ball's already moving at 1,000 miles an hour then. So the ball's not going to deviate from straight then.
Everything is moving 1,000 miles per hour.
So the ball's already moving 1,000 miles an hour, then it is going to move straight because it's already moving at the velocity of the moving platform beneath it.
These 1,000 miles per hour.
So the ball is already moving 1,000 miles an hour. You seem to be not recognizing that your current statement stands in violation of your ball deviating because Earth's moving underneath it. Now we've got the ball retaining 1,000 miles an hour, right?
Of course, because it has...
Oh, so it's not deviating then. So it stands in complete contradiction of your assertion that Earth would turn underneath it then. If it's retaining 1,000 miles an hour, it's not going to have Earth turning underneath it, you clown. It's a contradiction.
No, Nathan, look, the point is if you let the ball go, it has a linear path, while you still have that circular path around the Earth. That's why the ball will deviate.
Oh, so the ball's got Earth turning underneath it then, so it's not retaining 1,000 miles an hour then. So that's in complete contradiction to what you said
you
2 seconds
say
ago.
You're theoretically turning away from the...
Yeah, you've just said everything's got 1,000 miles an hour turning, and my drone apparently retains that 1,000 miles an hour. I ask if the ball retains it, you say what? No? Sigh for me, that's right, yeah. It's a contradiction, my friend. You can't have Earth retaining 1,000 miles an hour velocity in the drone and not retaining it in the ball. But that wrecks your example where the ball isn't retaining it, it's drifting because Earth's moving underneath it. They're in complete contradiction, my friend.
Nathan, this experiment is about...
Not an experiment, how dare you? This is an experiment, shut up.